Hello, everyone, and thank you for watching. Thank you for viewing. Thank you, everyone who has been tuning in over the past 14 days of these devotionals we've been doing, and this 21 days of prayer and fasting. This is the year of Overflow 2018. And we were just talking and mentioning how many people have already begun to step into the overflow already. And so we praise God for that. I thank you. Thank you so much. Many of you have been so faithful every single day. You're watching these. You're following along in the Word of God. You're praying, fasting. You're sharing it on Facebook and all that, you know, through social media. And so we thank you so much for doing that. Just want to quickly let you know that if you know someone that does not do Facebook, don't have a Facebook account, they can find these devotionals on our YouTube channel at Abundant Life Revival Network, or they can go on our website at AbundantLifeChurch.com. But however they want to access it, we want them to get these devotionals because God is doing an amazing thing. I've heard so many testimonies from how God is moving to the point to where God dealing with people and getting things out of their lives, to the point where people are saying, hey, man, God touched my life in such a way. I feel like I'm ready to run for the Lord again, all the way down to people just finding the call of God, just all kinds of testimonies. So I thank you for viewing today. Today is day 15 of our 21 days of prayer and fasting. Listen, you've already made it 14 days. You've got 7 days. You're going to make it. I believe in you. I'm praying for you. And I know the Lord believes in you as well. Just real quick, if you don't have this bookmark, go on our website, download it, look at it. It's got a prayer focus on one side of how you can pray for this church. And then it also has the scripture references of which we are doing the devotionals with every single day. So grab this bookmark. Goes right in line with the 21 days of overflow. Now, before I get started in the word today, I just want to say this. First 7 days was about emptying us of us. And so that was amazing how God moved by his spirit in doing that in the lives of so many people. Last week was about being full of the Holy Spirit. This week is about overflowing in the Spirit, overflowing with God. So this week, we're going to kind of transition, if you will, from dealing with what's going on in us to now going to some of the deeper things of God so that we can walk in the overflow. So I just want to let you know that before we get started. So today I want you to turn in your Bibles to 2 Corinthians chapter 13, and we're going to read verse 14. Chapter 13, and we're going to read verse 14. Now, it's a very quick, just one verse in 2 Corinthians, but it says so much. Now, listen to what the Bible says here. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion and the fellowships, that word's fellowship there. Some Bible say communion, some say fellowship, but and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Now, I just want to talk to you real quickly about communing with the Holy Spirit, because we've already dealt with getting with us being emptied of us. Last week, we was talking about being full of the Spirit, but in order for you to overflow, in order for you to overflow in the Spirit, in order for you to walk in the overflow, you've got to transition from the point of where the Spirit moving in your life is an event to where it becomes a lifestyle. And in other words, where the Holy Spirit is leading, directing, influencing, inspiring everything you say, everything you do, everything you think, everything you feel. Every thought, all that. The Holy Spirit wants to do this in your life. And this is possible. It is the communion with the Holy Ghost. And so this is what the Apostle Paul is telling the church of Corinth. He says, may the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Now, if you'll read 1 Corinthians and 2 Corinthians, you will realize that the Apostle Paul is writing under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. And he's correcting several things in the church of Corinth. And the last thing he writes under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit to the Corinthian church is, and may the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Now, why did he say this? Because listen, if you will just commune with the Holy Spirit, then you'll realize that the Holy Spirit will keep you out of the stuff and the things that you're not to be doing. He will keep you away from the stuff that's trying to rob from you, kill you, destroy you. He will keep you out of the lifestyle that Satan's trying to trap you in. He will keep you away from putting your mouth on people. He'll keep you out of all of this because the communion, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit is what is leading, directing, and guiding your life every day. So in order for you to overflow and walk in the overflow, there's going to have to be the communing of the Holy Spirit, the fellowship with the Holy Spirit on a daily basis. This is when this revelation hit me. I was probably 6 months after I had gotten saved and filled with the Holy Spirit. And the revelation hit me that I could commune with the Holy Ghost on a daily basis. The revelation hit me that the Spirit of God was there with me on a daily basis, minute by minute, hour by hour, day by day, and that he desired to speak with me. He desired to talk with me. He desired to reveal things to me. He desired to lead and guide me on a daily basis. When that revelation, not just the knowledge of it, but when the revealed word hit me, it began to change everything about my life. It changed my prayer life. It changed my walk with Christ. It changed how I read the Bible. It changed how I minister. It changed how I perceive situations because I realized that the Holy Spirit is not just coming and going. He's not just here 1 minute and then gone the next, but I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. And so the Holy Spirit is right there with me. And many times all he's wanting me to do is acknowledge him and then say, Holy Spirit, what do you want me to do about this? So we want to talk about this today because God has an overflow for the body of Christ. And I'm telling you, it's one like you have never, ever seen before. But this overflow is going to require the communion with the Holy Spirit. So I want to go somewhere after saying that. I want us to go to Acts chapter 16. Acts chapter 16. And we're going to go to verse 6. I want you to see something today. I want to give you just kind of an example of what happens when you are communing with the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 16 and verse 6. Now listen to what the Bible says. Now, when they had gone through Phrygia, the region of Galatia, they were forbidden by the Holy Spirit to preach the word in Asia. Now, think about this. They were forbidden by the Holy Spirit to preach the word in Asia. Now, you would think that when it comes to preaching the word, it doesn't matter where you go. It doesn't matter who you're talking to. You just need to get out and preach the word. But listen, the Apostle Paul had been filled with the Holy Spirit. He's being led by the Spirit. He's communing with the Spirit. And the Holy Spirit steps in his path and says, listen, you're not going to Asia. I don't want you going to Asia. I've got something else for you. How do you hear these things? How can you be led in such a way to where God is directing, no, don't go to that place. I want you going to that place. It takes the communing with the Holy Spirit. It takes the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Now listen to what the Bible says. And after they had come to Mysia, they tried to go up to Bithynia, but the Spirit didn't permit them to do that either. He stopped them then. Now, how are they being led in such a way? It's the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Watch this now. So passing by Mysia, they come down to Troas. And a vision appeared to Paul in the night, and a man of Macedonia stood and pleaded with him, saying, come over to Macedonia and help us. Now, after that, after he had seen the vision, immediately we sought to go to Macedonia, concluding that the Lord had called us to preach the gospel to them. What happens here? Because the Apostle Paul and those that are traveling with him are communing with the Holy Spirit. This is the first time that the gospel of Jesus Christ, it no longer goes east, but turns and starts coming west, which is the reason why many of us here in the West, the United States of America, have the gospel preached to us now. This is why, because because somebody was communing with the Holy Spirit and just wasn't presumptuous about where they needed to go, but asked the Holy Spirit, what do you want me to do, Holy Spirit? You stopped me here, you stopped me here. And then here comes this vision, and he says, okay, we're to go there. Now think about this. Think about just today in your everyday walk, your everyday ministering, you're at work, grocery store, at school, at college, whatever you do, maybe you're at home with kids. Think about this. Think about if you woke up in the morning and your number one objective was to begin to commune with the Spirit and begin to ask Him, Holy Spirit, what do you want today? What do you want to do? What do you want to say? How do you want to move in my life? What direction do you want to take me? Who do you want me to speak to? What do you want me to do? Think about if you begin to wake up and ask the Holy Spirit that. Think about how different your life will be. Think about the favor and the grace that will begin to abound in your life, because you're not waking up saying, I'm about to do this, this, and this, and this. You're waking up saying, Holy Spirit, what do you want to do? And that direction of the Holy Spirit will begin to take you in places that you've never dreamed you could go. You see, we're talking about be overflowing. We're talking about overflowing in the communion of the Holy Spirit. And this is what it's going to require. Now, I want you to think about this. If you invited me and my family and some other friends over to your house for evening, and we were going to maybe cook out and just do some things and just hang out together, we're going to fellowship together, so to speak, and you never said one word to anybody at the house, you just sat there and just pretty much stayed to yourself and never talked to anybody, I just dare to think that next time you invited us all over, we wouldn't come, because there was really no fellowship. We were just in each other's presence, but the fellowship was that which happens through conversation, which happens through the sharing of feelings. This is what the Holy Spirit desires from you. The Holy Spirit desires that on a daily basis, He shares His feelings with you. You share His feelings with Him. You talk with Him. You walk with Him. In prayer with Him. And when He says, hey, I want you to go over there and tell that person that Jesus loves them. This is the fellowship. This is the communing. When you open the Word of God, when I open the Word of God, I always say, Holy Spirit, show me and reveal to me what the Word is saying. Because the Holy Spirit is the author. He wrote it. He helped men, inspired of the Holy Spirit, pen this, but it came from the Holy Spirit. And so this fellowship is what's going to help you begin to walk in the overflow of God. Now, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to pray in just a moment. And we're going to ask God for a deep and continuous communion or fellowship with the Holy Spirit. We're going to let the Holy Spirit know our desire or our desires for His fellowship, for our desires to be led by Him, for our desires to be inspired by Him. And we're going to ask Him to share with us what grieves Him, and to share with us what makes Him rejoice. Because you must understand something. One of the things about having fellowship and knowing someone, your best friend or your closest person in the family that you're real close with, one of the things that helps you to know them in that way, one of the things that helps you to have that close friendship with that person is because you know what makes them, what ticks them off. You know what makes them hot. You know what turns around and makes them mad. And you know what makes them rejoice. And they know that about you. And so they respect those boundaries. They respect those. They reverence those boundaries. And that's what brings a close friendship. Well, when the Holy Spirit begins to share with you about what grieves Him, what makes Him rejoice, what makes Him happy, then as you begin to walk those boundary lines, then you'll understand that the communion and the fellowship begins to go at a deeper level. Because now you're living your life and you don't want to do what grieves the Holy Spirit. You don't want to do what, you don't want to do what hurts him. Jesus said this, every word spoken against the Son of Man will be forgiven. Now, but listen now. But he says that which is spoken against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven. Why did he say that? Because the Holy Spirit can be grieved. The Holy Spirit can be hurt. The Holy Spirit can be hurt in such a way to where it takes a while to get the communion back, the fellowship back with the Holy Spirit. So today, this is a part of the overflow. This is day 15. This is Monday. And this week, I wanted to start with this one, because this week, you're going to remember every single day, there's going to be something in the bottom of your soul saying, you need to commune with the Spirit. You need to commune with the Spirit. You need to fellowship with the Holy Spirit. You need to ask the Holy Spirit, what does he want from you today? What does he want you to do today? Ask this question too. Holy Spirit, what can I do today that will make you happy? I'm just telling you, some of you might think I'm crazy, but this is the deep part. This is the overflow that I'm telling you about. This is the overflow. And when you begin to step into this level, nothing is impossible. So today, let's ask the Holy Spirit to begin to talk with us about what grieves him, what makes him rejoice. And then listen, let's ask the Holy Spirit to help us to guard this communion, guard this fellowship with him. And as you begin to do this, God's going to open some things in your life in a powerful way. So let's pray today. I want you to pray with me starting out. And then after that, I'm going to pray for you today. Okay, but I just want you to repeat this. Just say this. Say, Father, in Jesus' name, I ask this day for a deep and continuous fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, let me know what you desire from my life. Let me know what grieves you, what makes you happy, what you rejoice over, and quicken me to do exactly that. I desire a deep fellowship with you, Holy Spirit. Quicken me and help me to guard this communion that I have with you. I ask this in the name of Jesus. Now, Father, I pray for every person watching, for every person listening. Father, I thank you for them today, and I ask today that there would be such a communion that begins to start in them, such a deep cry for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. I ask, Father, in the name of Jesus, that every single day they are alive on this earth, that they wake up and begin to commune with the Holy Spirit, are led by the Spirit, are directed by the Spirit, are guided by the Spirit, influenced and inspired by the Spirit, empowered by the Spirit. Father, I ask right now in Jesus' name that your Holy Spirit would begin to invade the lives of people right now, arrest their hearts, arrest their minds. God, we don't want to be led by ourselves anymore. We want to be led by the Spirit. And so, Father, right now, I am believing in the strong name of Jesus that you are doing this right now, that the Holy Spirit is beginning to reveal things to people and beginning to open up closed doors in people. And Father, I thank you for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit right now. I thank you for the communion with the Holy Spirit right now. And Father, I thank you. Jesus said, I will not leave you as orphans, but I will come to you. And we know that he spake that of the Holy Spirit. And so, Father, right now in Jesus' name, I pray that your Holy Spirit will begin to manifest your presence in people's lives. And I pray, God, that he'll put a fire and a power and an anointing down in them right now. And God, that deep will begin to cry out to deep. And God, I pray right now, let every open spot of the depths of their soul that is closed open up. In the name of Jesus, open up. And God, I pray right now that that communion with the Holy Spirit will begin to enrich and go deeper and deeper on a daily basis. I thank you for this right now in the name of Jesus. I thank you for this right now. I believe that right now. And Father, I pray for the Compassion Ministries of this church, of this ministry, the Abundant Life Ministry. I pray right now for our Compassion Ministries, God. I ask that you would send resources. I ask that you would send finances. I ask, God, that you would send laborers, Father, to come and do the work for the harvest is truly white. The fields are white and they're ready to be harvested. So, Father, I ask in Jesus' name, anoint our Compassion Ministries, empower our Compassion Ministries, bless those who serve in them, grant them favor, grant them grace, open doors of ministry for us in the name of Jesus. And I ask, God, let your heart be deposited in it. Let the mind of Christ be deposited in it. Let the anointing of the Spirit be deposited in it. And Father, we thank you for supplying for us, and we thank you for opening doors for us. In the name of Jesus, we bless our Compassion Ministries today, God, and we thank you for it. Listen, beloved, thank you for watching today. And I know there's a holy hush that is happening in your heart right now. I know there's a holy hush that is coming over you right now, and that is the Holy Spirit of God doing a deep work inside of you. And what he's doing is he's coming and he's just saying, hey, listen, I don't want to just be kept on the surface. I don't want to just be your church God. I want to be the God that you acknowledge in and over your life every single day. Let me lead you. Let me guide you. Let me help you. Amen and amen. Listen, thank you so much. Do not stop once this video ends right here. I want you to keep going. I want you to keep pursuing. I want you to keep fellowshipping with the Holy Spirit. And I'm telling you, things are about to open up in a mighty way. This is the third week, the beginning of the third week, and you're overflowing in the Spirit of God. We love you, and we'll see you tomorrow. God bless.
Thank you for joining us for the Abundant Life Church 21 Days of Overflow devotional series. For more information about this fast, Abundant Life Church, more videos, or how you can support the ministry, check us out at abundantlifechurch.com or download the free Abundant Life Church app.